My name is Sarah Ann Johnson. I'm from Winnipeg. I live and I work in Winnipeg still. I guess I'll give a bit of history, where this work comes from. In the 1950s, my grandmother was suffering from postpartum depression, which wasn't a thing back then. There was no diagnosis. So she was seeking help in Winnipeg, wasn't getting any better. Someone suggested she check herself into the Allan Memorial Institute in Montreal to be treated by Dr. Ewan Cameron, who was apparently doing breakthrough research at the time. She went to Montreal, she checked in the hospital. She was involved in the hospital on and off for 3 years, sometimes as an inpatient and sometimes as an outpatient. She had an apartment right close to the hospital, and so she would just go in for daily treatments. And afterwards, she was just so much worse. And they couldn't understand why she just kept getting so much worse. And it wasn't until the 70s, my grandfather was reading the Sunday New York Times, and there was an expose on CIA funding. And he recognized some of the foundation names in regards to the hospital and the doctor from when my nan was a patient there. And they did some digging, and they found out that she wasn't being treated for her illness, that the doctor was being funded by the Canadian government and the CIA, with full knowledge of the Canadian government, to run brainwashing experiments on his patients without their knowledge or consent. So this is LSD, shock treatment, prolonged periods of sleep. And so she was obviously very angry when she found out. And first they sued the hospital, and then she went after the CIA, which is crazy, because who goes after the CIA? My grandma. Even after all they did to her, she was still a super tough, strong, amazing woman. And so this was an important piece of Canadian history. It was also an important piece of my family history. I made a body of work called House on Fire in 2010, and a performance called Dancing with the Doctor in 2011, which is also showing here at the SAG. And this new piece is called Hospital Hallway, and it is a institutional looking hallway in the shape of an octagon. And how it exists now in the gallery is there's a door and you walk in, and there's 15 TV screens that show me. Each screen is one movement or gesture on a loop, so it's like never ending. So you walk around this hallway, it feels a lot bigger when you're inside, and when you get to the other side, you can't tell which is north or south. You start to get a little lost in the space, and you can hear banging and thumping and gasping from videos that you can't see yet, so it adds the sense of anxiety. There was also a performance. So before the video screens went in, and before the door was cut out, it was just a hallway with no entrance, no exit. And I got put inside of it. And then there's a catwalk around it. So the audience comes, and I'm already in there. The performance has already started, so people come and they watch, and I'm doing all these strange, difficult, torturous movements. That are very physically strenuous and I guess a little hard to watch. And so the audience watches from above and while I'm doing it, and then after half an hour they leave me in there still doing it. So it never starts and it never ends. It's just always kind of going. I was hoping that people would walk in and then feel that anxiety from the sounds that they don't know where it's coming from yet, and the space, it's a horrible space to be in. So it's like hoping that they would get like a physical reaction to it and feel uncomfortable and feel like it was not a place that they wanted to spend a lot of time in. Is that having me down there and people looking up from above, that it put them in a difficult situation. Someone said that there's only two places in life. You're either like in it or you're witnessing it. I'm interested in how something can come in out of left field, break a branch on the family tree, and how that sorts itself out generation to generation, because I wasn't even around when this all happened, but I like feel like it is such a huge part of me and who I am. It's really strange making work about someone who you love and who's no longer around, because I have all these memories of her, and it's great to get to sit my mom down and ask her questions about my grandmother. So I get to learn more about my grandmother, and I get to learn more about my mom, because I feel like I get to understand her better through this whole process also. It's so abstracted, like I'm taking an idea like hospital hallway is, it's about me trying to understand what someone would go through when they are, like when they lose themselves mentally, physically, and spiritually to an institution who means them harm. And that's kind of an act, like it's inspired by the events that happened to my grandmother, but it changes and it goes up in a, you know, different places. And so then I often worry that it's changing my memory of my grandmother, which I don't know that I like. I don't know. I've been thinking more about that recently with this piece, actually. But one amazing thing that happened when I first showed Dancing with the Doctor, I kept wanting my mom to come to a rehearsal so that she could see it in an informal way and get used to the imagery and get used to the movement, because I didn't know how she was going to react to it, and she wouldn't come. And so she's like, she just wanted to come to the performance. So what I did was I organized a night for just family and friends, and it was like a pre-opening, so it was smaller, and it was just all the dancers' friends and family, and my friends and family, and so she got through the piece. Afterwards, everybody's getting up and leaving, and my mom was just sitting there, and you could see that there were tears starting to well up in her eyes, and. So my dad and my brother and I formed a protective circle around her. And I was like, are you okay? Like, you know, what's gonna happen? Are you okay? And she's like, you know, I've only been angry at her all these years. And so I've never stopped to think about what it was like for her. And now after seeing this piece, I'm not angry anymore. I mean, that's amazing. You know, I didn't care what anyone said after that. It's like, that's you know, just the most incredible thing that could have happened, that could have come from making that piece.